This is Father Jim Korda. On behalf of your Catholic friends and neighbors in the Diocese of Youngstown, I invite you to join us for this celebration of the Holy Mass.
Let us please stand and welcome Father Matthew.
You are the salt for the earth, O people, salt for the kingdom of God. Share the flavor of life, O people, life in the kingdom of God. Bring forth the kingdom of mercy, bring forth the kingdom of peace, bring forth the kingdom of justice, bring forth the city of God. You are a light on the hill, O people, light for the city of God. Shine so holy and bright, O people, shine for the kingdom of God. Bring forth the kingdom of mercy, bring forth the kingdom of peace, bring forth the kingdom of justice, bring forth the city of God.
Good morning.
Good morning.
We welcome all of you who are here at our chapel at St. Paul Monastery in Ellsworth, Ohio, as well as those joining us over our ecumenical channel here in Northeast Ohio as we gather on this 24th Sunday in Ordinary Time. And let us come together in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
My brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. And may Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of good will. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One. You alone are the Lord. You alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit and the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. Look upon us, O God, creator and ruler of all things, and that we may feel the working of your mercy, grant that we may serve you with all our heart. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
Amen.
A reading from the book of Exodus. The Lord said to Moses, "Go down at once to your people, whom you brought out of the land of Egypt, for they have become depraved. They have soon turned aside from the way I pointed out to them, making for themselves a molten calf and worshiping it, sacrificing it, and crying out, "This is your God, O Israel, who brought you out of the land of Egypt." I see how stiff-necked this people is, continued the Lord to Moses. Let me alone then, that my wrath may blaze up against them to consume them. Then I will make you a great nation. But Moses implored the Lord, his God, saying, "Why, O Lord, should your wrath blaze up against your own people, whom you brought out of the land of Egypt with such great power and with such strong hand? Remember your servants Abraham, Isaac, and Israel, and how you swore to them by your own self, saying, 'I will make your descendants as numerous as the stars in the sky, and all this land that I promised, I will give your descendants as their perpetual heritage.'" So the Lord relented in his punishment he had threatened to inflict on his people. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
I will rise, I will rise, I will rise and go to my Father. I will rise, I will rise, I will rise and go to my Father. Have mercy on me, O God, in your goodness. In the greatness of your compassion, wipe out my offense. Thoroughly wash me from my guilt, and of my sins cleanse me. I will rise, I will rise, I will rise and go to my Father. Clean heart create for me, O God, and a steadfast spirit renew within me. Cast me not out from your presence, and your Holy Spirit take not from me. I will rise, I will rise, I will rise and go to my Father. I will rise, I will rise, I will rise and go to my Father. O Lord, open my lips, and my mouth shall proclaim your praise. My sacrifice, O God, is a contrite spirit, a heart contrite and humbled. O God, will you not spurn?
I will rise, I will rise, I will rise and go to my Father. I will rise, I will rise, I will rise and go to my Father. I will rise.
A reading from the letter of Saint Paul to Timothy. Beloved, I am grateful to him who has strengthened me, Christ Jesus, our Lord, because he considered me trustworthy in appointing me to the ministry. I was once a blasphemer and a persecutor and arrogant, but I have been mercifully treated because I acted out of ignorance in my unbelief. Indeed, the grace of our Lord has been abundant, along with the faith and love that are in Christ Jesus. This saying is trustworthy and deserves full acceptance. Christ Jesus came into the world to save sinners. Of these, I am the foremost. But for that reason, I was mercifully treated, so that in me, as the foremost, Christ Jesus might display his patience as an example for those who would come to believe in him for everlasting life. To the King of ages, incorruptible, invisible, the only God, honor and glory forever and ever. Amen. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Alleluia, 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 alleluia. God was reconciling the world to himself in Christ, and entrusting to us the message of reconciliation. Alleluia, 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 alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, Lord.
Tax collectors and sinners were all drawing near to listen to Jesus, but the Pharisees and scribes began to complain, saying, "This man welcomes sinners and eats with them." So to them he addressed this parable. A man had two sons, and the younger son said to his father, "Father, give me the share of your estate that should come to me." So the father divided the property between them. After a few days, the younger son collected all his belongings and set off to a distant country, where he squandered his inheritance on a life of dissipation. When he had freely spent everything, a severe famine struck that country, and he found himself in dire need. So he hired himself out to one of the local citizens, who sent him to his farm to tend the swine. And he longed to see his fill of the pods on which the swine fed, but nobody gave him any. Coming to his senses, he thought, "How many of my father's hired workers have more than enough food to eat? But here I am, dying from hunger. I shall get up and go to my father, and I shall say to him, 'Father, I have sinned against heaven and against you. I no longer deserve to be called your son. Treat me as you would treat one of your hired workers.'" So he got up and went back to his father. While he was still a long way off, his father caught sight of him and was filled with compassion. He ran to his son, embraced him, and kissed him. His son said to him, "Father, I have sinned against heaven and against you. I no longer deserve to be called your son." But his father ordered his servants, "Quickly, bring the finest robe and put it on him. Put a ring on his finger and sandals on his feet. Take the fattened calf and slaughter it. And then let us celebrate with a feast, because this son of mine was dead and has come to life again. He was lost and has been found." And then the celebration began. Now, the older son had been out in the field, and on his way back, as he neared the house, he heard the sound of music and dancing. He called one of the servants and asked what this might mean. And the servant said to him, "Your brother has returned, and your father has slaughtered the fattened calf because he has him back safe and sound." He became angry, and when he refused to enter the house, his father came out and pleaded with him. He said to his father in reply, "Look, all these years I served you, and not once did I disobey your orders, yet you never gave me even a young goat to feast on with my friends. But when your son returns, who swallowed up your property with prostitutes, for him you slaughter the fattened calf." He said to him, "My son, you were here with me always. Everything I have is yours. But now we must celebrate and rejoice, because your brother was dead and has come to life again. He was lost and has been found." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Again, it's good to have everybody here at our chapel, especially our young people. Did you bring your father with you today? Oh, welcome. Glad to have you with us. A few announcements before we begin our reflection. First of all, the kiosk in the back that's provided by the Knights of Columbus that has lots of various books. It has been restocked, so feel free to grab a book you haven't read yet or something that you perhaps read and lost your book. It gives you some things to reflect about on your faith and to enrich your spiritual life. Also back there, there's a sheet of paper that says Catholic Penguins on the top, a picture of St. John Newman. It is about the Newman Center at the Youngstown State University for their students, and it talked about how the Dominicans have taken over the pastorship of that center, and a couple years ago, they only had about 6 to 10 people. They now have over 40 students who are coming to participate in that, and they're looking for some funding to help them do some of the programming and keep the place open and do some different things. They're asking for monthly donations, but I'm sure if you just sent a one-time donation, because that's what you can afford, they'll appreciate it. So the information is on that sheet. Also in the back are just a few copies left of our Catholic Exponent, which actually came out last week, but if we don't get it in our mailbox on Friday or Saturday, it doesn't come in until Monday, or this week it didn't come until Tuesday, that means you get it a week later. But you can look at it if you don't receive one at home. On the very back page is a picture taken of our blessing of our store on August 20th, so you read that. It's also the vocation issue, so if you open it up and turn towards the back, you'll have the vocation story of Brother Marco Bogarelli, who is our regional superior, and of hear how he became a brother in the Society of St. Paul. Quite a little interesting story you might want to read. I ask you to pray for Brother Marco. We took him to the Cleveland Clinic on Thursday afternoon. I spent my 5 hours in the emergency room with him before they decided they were going to keep him. They put, he had retained a lot of water in his system, so they put a couple of drains for his bile ducts, also a drain in his chest cavity, and he's wired up and he's got the feeding tube in his nose and whatever, but he is in good spirits. He was talking to us yesterday and texting me this morning, so he's doing okay, but please keep him in your prayers, and we hope to get him back sometime this week. In today's gospel, we hear the story of what has always been known as the parable of the prodigal son, but I'm going to say it's actually the parable of the prodigal family. Because you have to look at, first of all, what is the definition of prodigal? One of the definitions, which is more of the negative one, is squandering something, getting rid of something, not using your resources, not using your gifts very well. You don't give yourself fully, and so you squander those things. And the other is a more positive, which is to lavish, which means you take your gifts and your resources and you do give it away, but you're giving it away because you want to share your abundance with others. And so we have both of those aspects of being a prodigal in today's gospel reading. We have the first son, the younger son, who basically comes to his dad and said, I wish you were dead. Because of the fact that you normally don't get your legacy or your inheritance until after your parents have passed away. And so he's basically saying, I want it now, I don't want to wait for you, so I wish that you were dead so I could get it right now. But his father was compassionate, loving, divided it up between his sons and gave his younger son the inheritance, who went off and he squandered it. He spent it all. And then there was a great famine, and then he was in pain and suffering, and he realized how he had squandered two things in his life. The first thing he had squandered was all the money that he had received. And the second thing is he had actually squandered his relationship with his father. And I can almost envision that his father and maybe their mother, even though she's not mentioned in this parable, were trying to teach their children, their sons, on how to relate to one another, how to have a relationship with God in their life, how to relate to their servants that they had for them, how they could be caregivers and how they could become great businessmen and how they could utilize their gifts in their life. But here he had given all that up. And so he was going to come back to his father and said, I sinned. I sinned against you. I sinned against God. I have pained you. I have hurt you. And I'm not even worthy now to be called your son. I want to be just one of your servants. And so that is the way he returns back to his father. Now, we want to skip to the second part after the son returns, and I'll come back to that in a moment. We have the second son. Now, the second son had remained faithful, but he, too, was a prodigal son because he had squandered his relationship with his father, first of all, thinking that his father could only judge him that he was a good son because he remained faithful. He didn't realize his father was loving him unconditionally. No matter what he would have done, whatever decisions he would have made, he would have loved him just as he loved the younger son. He also had squandered his relationship with his brother because of the fact that he was comparing himself. I stayed at home, your brother ran away. He spent all your money. But here I kept your money, I kept your legacy, I kept doing things, but he still wasn't having that strong relationship. And so he refused to even come in and talk to his father. And now we have the prodigal father, who was one who taught his children, loved his children unconditionally, was willing to help them in many ways. And he did not forget his younger son. He was constantly on looking for him, praying for him. And so when his son was coming back, he saw him from a distance and ran out to greet him, hugged him, kissed him, welcomed him home, put the fancy clothes on. Let's celebrate because this son of mine was lost and is found, is dead and is now back to life. And we need to celebrate this life. We need to celebrate the family being together. We need to celebrate all the gifts that the Lord has shared in our life. And the celebration began. But then we see the older son didn't come in. So again, the father had to go out to meet his son and said, we have to rejoice. Everything I have is still yours. I still love you. Our brother has been lost and is found and is dead and has come to life. Let us come back together as a family. So we bring all of this to ourselves today, and I propose that we are prodigal sons and daughters. First of all, we may at times in our relationship with God told God, we don't need you. I stopped praying. I stopped going to church. I stopped receiving the body and blood of Christ. I stopped the sacraments. I stopped having any religion or faith or spirituality in my life. I can do it on my own. And then we come to find out that we do need a presence of the Lord. We need to have that relationship. So we come back and say, Lord, I have sinned. I found out that I have to have you in my life. And we turn to prayer, we return to the sacraments, we return to reading the Word of God, and our lives are rejoicing because we're utilizing the gifts and the abilities and the talents the Lord has given us to bring great hope into the world. Or at times we might be the prodigal son who has broken that relationship with family. Maybe we've started comparing ourselves with our brothers and sisters. Maybe we haven't talked to parents or children or our brothers and sisters, and maybe we've even forgotten why we've not talked to each other all these many years. And this is an opportunity to come back and say, I am sorry. I'm come back and say, I don't remember why. There's a way to rejoice in the goodness of one another instead of comparing and putting each other down, but appreciating the gifts of one another. And then we want to be like the Father that love one another unconditionally, to show the presence and the power of the Lord in our life. And in this way, we do become prodigal fathers, brothers, sisters, sons, and daughters, because we are sharing the fullness of the unconditional love, mercy, and the forgiveness of the Lord with one another. Let us stand together now and share our profession of faith. And this morning we will again say the Apostles' Creed. I believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell, and on the third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From there he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. As faithful disciples of the Lord, we turn now to God with our needs and the needs of our brothers and sisters in Christ.
For the church, that we may recognize the length and depth of God's love for us and reach out to all who have become estranged from God or the Christian community, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For a renewed understanding of the sacrament of reconciliation, that we may be open to God's gift of mercy and unbounded forgiveness, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for those who perished in the attacks of September 11th, 2001, and for those who continue to suffer from that event, that they may find comfort in the support of loved ones and in the loving embrace of our God, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for the homebound, that they may know God's healing presence and entrust themselves and their caregivers to God's loving care, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for families that are alienated or in conflict, that God will remove the barriers and heal their hurts and that they have caused division, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for Brother Marco and all those who are ill, that they may know God's healing presence and entrust themselves to God's loving care, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And as we pray this Mass, let us remember Diana and Joseph Collinger. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Glorious and merciful God, look with favor on your people, listening to the prayers we make today and always through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Amen.
Will you let me be your servant? Let me be as Christ to you. Pray that I may have the grace to let you be my servant too. We are pilgrims on a journey. We are travelers on the road. We are here to help each other walk the mile and bear the load.
light for you. In the night time of your fear, I will hold my hand out to you. Speak the peace you long to hear. I will weep when you are weeping. When you laugh, I'll laugh with you. I will share your joy and sorrow till we've seen this journey through.
Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
Sacrifice at your hands, the praise and glory of his name.
Look with favor on our supplications, O Lord, and in your kindness accept these, your servants' offerings, that what each one has offered to the honor of your name may serve the salvation of all, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For you so loved the world that in your mercy you sent us, the Redeemer, to live like us in all things but sin, so that you might love in us what you loved in your Son, by whose obedience we have been restored to those gifts of yours, that by sinning we had lost in disobedience. And so, Lord, with all the angels and saints, we too give you thanks as in exaltation we acclaim. Indeed, holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and David, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other a sign of peace. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world, and blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Act of spiritual communion for those unable to be with us today. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the Blessed Sacrament. I love you above all things and desire to receive you into my soul, since I cannot receive you sacramentally. Come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Amen.
beyond the moon and stars, as deep as night. So
Let us pray. May the working of this heavenly gift, O Lord, we pray, take possession of our minds and bodies, so that its effects and not our own desires may always prevail in us through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Again, thank all of you for joining us, our chapel here at St. Paul Monastery in Ellsworth, Ohio. Also those joining us over our ecumenical channel here in Northeast Ohio. I thank our musicians, our reader, and just remind you that our store is open until 12 noon today. Stop over and say hello to those who are over there. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our Mass is ended. Let us go in peace.
Amen.